Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another special episode of Feed Frank Friday. Tonight, we are going to be sampling Lone River Ranch water. Also have a special guest next to me.
Hello, I'm Ashley.
Yep, Ashley actually made a guest appearance on the Chicago Handshake episode. Due to time constraints, we had to cut her from that. Both of us are connected by tequila. Ranch water, believe it or not, is tequila, Topo Chico, or any kind of seltzer, and lime. That is ranch water.
Okay.
We have a couple different flavors that we're going to sample tonight. Really excited. Are you excited?
I'm very excited.
Legend has it, the first soul to taste ranch water followed miles of Texas stars until found asleep under, what, that doesn't make any sense.
And found, and was.
There's no was there.
There is no was there.
No.
And found.
Found asleep.
Under a.
Pinata
tree. While what transpired on that journey remains a mystery, reading this can remains a mystery. I still don't. Sampling tonight, we have original ranch water, so tequila, seltzer, lime. We also have Rio Red grapefruit, followed by prickly pear, and then we're gonna cap everything off with spicy. The first one we're gonna start out is with the OG, original gangster, if you will. Take a look at the can there. Say, we see the ranch water can. Pretty basic, pretty simple. Can I ask you a question? Can you open that for me? How do you open cans? Oh, like a normal human. See, I get yelled at for doing my thumb and turning it sideways, sticking it straight up your candy ass.
You do what?
Yes, a man!
Oh, we're going full glasses here.
Look how even I poured that. Give it a little smell. It smells limey. I smell lime.
It does. Yeah.
Lime is what stands out to me.
And it smells like a watered down margarita or tequila drink.
Maybe watered down margarita.
Mm-hmm. Chips.
What is that? What's happening?
It's definitely not strong as far as tequila.
No, it's a tequila candy. They're only 4%. They're not very. They are very strong.
80 calories,
4%.
Maybe over a lot of ice. Maybe add a little extra shot of tequila to it. It'd be a good mixer. With tequila.
Yeah, I'd have to add more booze to this.
But I guess, you know, with day drinking and...
Sure, I mean, this is better than just, you know, tossing straight tequila down your gullet during the day.
Not bad, just easy.
Not bad, just easy.
Not easy drinking, yeah. It's not as artificial as some of the seltzers.
Is this actually made with tequila? No.
It says alcohol.
Alcohol from sugar. Okay.
Scares me.
We forge ahead to the Rio Red grapefruit. Rio Red grapefruit.
And there is actually Rio Red grapefruit in the ingredients.
Oh, look at that.
Not just red grapefruit.
Take a look at the can. There it is. Hook 'em horns. See, sideways stop. That's how I opened it.
Yeah, that
that's
was interesting.
Wow, it's weird, right?
I expected this one to have a little tint to it.
Tint. Just poured that all over my leg. Yeah. Alright, let's give it a smell. Okay, grapefruit is strong with the...
You can taste or smell that real red grapefruit.
Say that 10 times fast.
It smells good. I'm not a big grapefruit fan.
Let's try it out. Cheers. Where the hell did the grapefruit go?
I don't know.
It's gone. It just tastes like the other stuff.
It tastes like the other one, yeah. Not even an aftertaste of grapefruit.
Mm. Pause it in your mouth for a second. And on your tongue, you can feel the tart.
Yeah.
Feel it on your tongue.
Don't drink them too fast, because you'll miss out on that Rio Red grapefruit taste.
Also, don't pour them on your leg, because it's sticky.
They do go down very easy.
Yeah, these, they're like super easy. The tartness, it doesn't overwhelm.
Not at all.
I mean, it's almost non-existent.
That's the thing with seltzer. Sometimes they just, it overwhelms
it. Yeah, the flavor can sometimes be a little overwhelming, but this is good. So far, you're preferring the Ruby Red to the
OG. So far, yeah.
Just the slight tartness, but pretty much tastes the exact same. Outside of that slight tartness on the top.
Yeah.
Next up on our list, prickly pear. Take a look at the can. Okay. All the cans pretty much look the same. Color scheme changes a little bit based on what it is. Prickly pear. All I know prickly pear from is the Jungle Book. It's like, you get the prickly pear and the prickly pear.
So, but what's a prickly pear?
It's not
like a Midwestern pear.
What's a Midwestern pear?
Ooh.
Oh, I like it. This smells really good. I taste the prickly pear.
Oh, yeah.
You take a drink of the prickly pear, and I'll take a drink of the prickly pear.
Yeah, I like this one. I'd say this one by far.
It has the most flavor.
But not overpowering.
Right. And I don't know what a prickly pear tastes like, but this tastes good. This is good.
It is.
I'm trying to wrap my mind around the taste. It's still a little tart. It is.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little tart, but sweet at the same
time.
Right. It's prickly pear, like cactus. Is it like cactus? I mean, that would make sense. It's Texas.
It's good, whatever it is.
These go down super
they
easy.
They do. Way too easy. I mean,
super easy, like dangerous easy.
Yes, exactly. This could be trouble.
We move on to our very last one, which is the spicy.
I love spicy, but something about
booze spice,
jalapenos specifically,
boozy,
mess me up. Made with 100% agave, natural lime juice, and jalapeno flavors, and I am not seeing actual jalapeno.
Why do you keep saying it like that?
It's not like the Midwest way to say it. Like I said, jalapenos. How you supposed to say that? Jalapeno. Jalapeno.
That's. Are you Italian? I got the jalapeno.
It's a jalapeno.
I put it on the pizza.
That's so spicy.
Boozy spice. Boozy spice. That's actually my favorite spice girl. If you don't like it, I'll drink it. You can take a sip.
Ooh, I
kind of
feel that in my nose already. Sorry.
Already.
I'm ahead a little bit.
No, that's okay.
Ooh.
All the way around the lake by myself.
Been around the lake and Jesus, can you put some sunscreen on?
How do you say jalapeno?
Do you say it like an Italian?
Jalapeno. Jalapeno.
What?
Midwesterners say jalapeno.
Did you just have to fake a Midwest accent? From Michigan.
Going to get some jalapenos.
All right, ready?
Ooh.
Here we go.
It lingers.
The nice thing about it though is it's hitting here. It's not my mouth is on fire.
It's a nice
burn. Feel it in your nose.
Mm-hmm.
Outside of the prickly pear, to be honest, they've all kind of tasted the same. But this one, you know what reminds me of? When I used to drink apple cider vinegar with cayenne in the morning.
Oh.
That's
what. Heard of the cayenne in it. But yeah, it's definitely, like, if you want something spicy and you're looking for, like, a little extra.
So me personally, and I think you're very similar as you're choking that down, I'm not a big fan of spicy in my drinks. You know how people, like, put jalapeno in their margaritas and stuff like that? That's just not me. I feel like no one in the world said, you know what I need right now in my ice cold beverage? Spice.
Little jalapeno.
You're not going to finish that.
No, I'm not.
And there it is. Ranch Waters Down. This one was watered down.
Margarita.
Watered down margarita.
Mm-hmm.
Watered down margarita with some tartness on the tongue.
Yep.
Delightful.
I love the prickly pear.
I want to eat a prickly pear.
Yes.
I need a prickly pear in my life. And then we had ranch water with cayenne. Everyone wants to know, do we recommend the Lone River Ranch Water? And then I'm going to default to you, Ashley. Would you recommend the OG itself?
I think this would be good, again, as a mixer. Like, especially if you don't have all the things, like, to make an actual margarita, or if you just have tequila and you're like, oh, I don't want to take a shot of this, right. But I want to sip on it.
I would agree.
I would go with just
you got to add to it. What about the Rio Red? It's not squirt.
I would probably put it in the same.
It's a mixer. I feel like it's a mixer, right?
Mm-hmm.
How about that prickly pear?
That I would drink by itself.
Yeah, that was really, really good. I strong recommend on the prickly pear.
Yes.
You take a drink of the prickly pear, and I'll take a drink. And then the spicy one.
Again, if somebody's looking for a seltzer with a little sprinkle of the cayenne pepper, that's what's left of mine.
Overall, okay, let's consider the entire variety pack. The tequila doesn't come through on this.
I was kind of hoping it would be tequila.
If they really had tequila in this, it would set it off a little bit more.
Because I don't taste any tequila.
Zero. I don't taste.
I was kind of hoping for that.
Yeah. Do we recommend ranch waters? I'm defaulting to you because this is your episode.
I would say yes. I would recommend them.
All right. Well, stamp the screen then. Hit stamp. It.
Stamp. Stamp.
Yeah.
Or with that.
Stamp. I'm covered up now. It's got the official Feed Frank Friday stamp for quality of approval. Thank you, Ashley, for joining me
on this episode
tonight. It was fantastic.
I am starting to feel a little buzzy from them.
I'm not feeling anything. I thank you all for watching. Please like, share, subscribe. F cubed out.
Found asleep under a pinyon tree.
Pinyon deuces.
Pinyon. Pinyon a la pinyon.
Now, when you pick a pawpaw or a prickly pear, and you prick a raw paw, well, next time, beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw.